Hallelujah. How many Bibles I have in the house? Woo! Good Bibles. I see electronic ones as well. I'm working for my electronic today as well. Turn to Hebrews chapter 12. Hebrews chapter 12. Woo! You know, I believe that God, the title of my message today is Keep Moving Forward. Is that speaking to anybody yet? Keep moving forward. I believe that God wants us to look back so that for a moment, just so that He can empower us to keep moving forward. This morning while I was in prayer, the Lord gave me a glimpse of the impact that Covenant Church has had over the past 20 years. I saw people coming, the people that have been coming since that first Sunday on September the 21st, 1997. The first 6 months of this church, we met in the Shriner Auditorium. How many of you were there? Can I see a hand? All over the place. And then after about, I think, 6 months, we moved into the back to that first building that was on the property under construction, which is called the Product Production and Distribution Building, which is where we have the ministry products that are shipped all over the world. But there was a space in the back that we left open for overflow, and we used that for the church for about 2.5 years. Right now it's called the Annex. And many of you have been in there now. It's used primarily for the youth on Wednesday nights, but we also use it for social events for the church. It's a really special spot. But then in October of 2000, we moved into this beautiful sanctuary, totally paid for by the glory of God. But in that this morning when I was praying, just in a moment, I saw people moving through the doors in fast speed. Like they were going through at a very fast speed. It was almost like you see those, anybody ever saw those images on TV when they'll take a traffic cam or they'll speed it up and you could see the cars going so fast. It was like a blur. And it almost looked like arteries in a body. They were just flowing and blowing through there. It was like a time-lapse video that I was able to sense and see for a moment of the many lives that have come through the building. It's in these almost 20 years now. It's really amazing to see what God has done and is doing. Some people come for a season. Some people come just for a service. They're visiting. I remember after Katrina, we had lots of people that were here that were working in the area to help restore. They were actually doing contract work, and they were working all week long, and they'd come and sit in the sanctuary, and they would get refreshed. And then they moved on. There were many of them that were coming during those times after Katrina in 2005 that had come because their church was blown away or washed away. And their congregations were not here. So Jesse often would tell them when he'd come in, he knew they were in the auditorium. He would tell them and exhort them, now look, when your church is built, you're going back there. We're not in competition. We're in cooperation. We believe in the body of Christ. Amen. And so God has brought many people through these doors that have come through events, special events that we've held, and many of them have come as church members to come and sit and be grow here. Some come for a season, some come for longer. But God has done a work in this place, amen? Amen. And so when He sped that 20 years in that one moment, it really impacted me. Because so often, you know, there's a lot that goes on with moving, of having a church, right? A lot of things behind the scenes you don't see. It's an effort. It's amazing. It's really a commitment to be obedient to what God said. And when God spoke to me many years ago and said that He wanted a church here in Destrehan that would be Spirit-filled, we stepped up to the plate and did it. And many of you are here today that stepped up with us and are pulling with us, realizing that the goal is not ours, it's God's. Amen? He has a plan. He has people that He wants to reach. He has lives that need to be changed. And the only way that that can happen is through the wonderful gospel of Jesus Christ, the full gospel, the whole Word of God. Amen? Being preached without compromise and stand boldly for what God has said. And that's what's so important. God has a purpose when He pulls us together. And He showed me that look back, that little glimpse of all the lives that He sees. He sees every soul that has passed through here. He sees everyone that's logged online. that has heard the word through this place. And he's watching over them. Amen. And the reason that I believe he showed me that is to remind me of this in Hebrews chapter 12. You know, when Hebrews chapter 12 begins, it's after Hebrews chapter 11. Does anybody get that? I know it's really genius of me to say that, but Hebrews chapter 12 comes after Hebrews chapter 11. And if any of you are Bible readers, you know that Hebrews chapter 11 is what many people call the heroes of the faith. It lists people, ordinary people like us, who were given supernatural assignments, impossible assignments, many of them. And they boldly believed God, and they stood on the word, and they believed his word, and they saw impossible things happen. And there was the whole, I'm not going to go through all of Hebrews 11, but y'all know that there were so many that God touched. And they saw miraculous things, dead raised from the dead. I mean, it was amazing. But here in Hebrews chapter 12, we're going to start with verse 1. And this is the wherefore he's talking about. Wherefore, seeing we are also encompassed about with so great a cloud of witnesses. So that cloud of witnesses was at Hebrews 11. He says, so let us lay aside every weight and the sin which so doth so easily beset us. And let us run with patience the race that is set before us, looking unto Jesus, the author and finisher of our faith, who for the joy that was set before him endured the cross, despising the shame, and is set down at the right hand of the throne of God. For consider him, hallelujah, that endured such contradiction of sinners against himself, lest ye be wearied and faint in your minds. That's a powerful passage of scripture. That's like an enlistment to get busy. Get going with what God called you to do. It's kind of like an exhortation to keep moving forward. Amen? Jesus focused on the joy that was set before him. His joy was so that all of us would be able to have a relationship with the Father, that we would come to the knowledge of the Father, and we would be born again and rescued from the pits of hell. Amen? I'm so glad that I prayed that prayer in 1973 and asked Jesus to come into my life. Had Jesus not gone to the cross, I couldn't have had that hope. I wouldn't have been able to be rescued. My marriage would have fallen apart. I wouldn't have had anything really to live for. I was just existing. I didn't have a full life like I have now. Jesus makes all that possible. So Jesus was focused on the joy that was set before him. He kept moving forward. He ran his race. He endured the cross and shame. See, no price was too high for him because of you. No price was too high for him because of me. He endured the cross and shame, and now he is at the right hand of God. The Father. So this verse declares that Jesus has a pre-appointed course for your race in life. You have somewhere to go. God has a purpose for your life, and you're not here by any accident. He wants to stir you up today so that you would keep on moving forward. Amen? Hi, I'm Kathy DePlantis. Thanks for watching our YouTube channel. Remember to subscribe and hit the notification bell to stay up to date with all things Jesse DePlantis Ministries. God bless.
This media is copyrighted by Jesse DePlantis Ministries for the private use of our audience. Any other use of this media or of any pictures or accounts without Jesse DePlantis Ministries' consent is strictly prohibited.